is the bigger drive home for a Thursday afternoon, which means, hallelujah, it is the weekend. In the meantime, 4 o'clock across the capital. Let's kickstart the big drive home. Playing out on Cairo's number one, it is Yanal FM. Interesting topic for the day. I want to talk about underground. What is underground to you? I'm talking places, I'm talking people, I'm talking music. So if you've got something to say about underground, get in touch.
We don't live in something permanent. It can change from a day to another.
Lebanon, Egypt, and the Gulf countries, Jordan and Syria. It's a region full of tension, an ensemble of struggling powers, and you don't know what's going to happen.
There's a vastly growing seed all over the place. It's an enormous amount of people who want to express differently and want to say real things. This is a revolution, an attempt to challenge norms.
Right now you're making a difference in the country at the time you need to. You know, we are ambassadors of our people. We're not just rappers, we're politicians, we're activists.
The thing that really introduces your culture to others is either religion, science, or art. Without it, they won't know about you, so let the people make music.
First time I understood that, wow, this is my culture, I came back from France because of civil war. I had been living for 4 or 5 years there. I had been disconnected with the country. I would listen to Arabic music, not connecting to it. I felt it was crap. But then going further into the lyrics and the poetry in the Arabic language, I felt, my God, this is a treasure, and it's just completely ignored. It moved me, it shook me, and I realized, wow, this is beautiful music. It doesn't resemble anything I know. but I just feel, I just connect to it. And then since then, I started working on a way to translate this Arabic feel into modern music. About war, and the content is about separation, and the content is about broken dreams. We're always in a frenzy of achieving. You know, you're not sure that the sun is gonna rise the next day, so you just make the best out of it. We are in our countries trying to have our society more open to the rest of the world, and we are not recognized at home. Media and radios do not have any interest in what we have to say. But there's a schizophrenia in the society, one ruling part that is conservative and intolerant and doesn't allow anything that is a bit sensual or a bit controversial. And on the other hand, a very, I'd say, decadent society, you know, a lot of drinking and sex and alcohol and parties.
It's very hard to be an artist here, especially when you're a girl. Like, they can have it all figured for you. And it's hard to be independent. Older families or older people, I don't see them being very respectful. And I don't see them looking at this as an actual job, you know?
At the same time, we are seen as idols from on the new generation.
Yeah, and that's for the young people, for sure.
And I think hopefully also a source of inspiration. In the Arab countries identify themselves with what we do, and they kind of understand this message of modernity that we try to express. So what's interesting also in our project in Lumi is that it's a female singer, and it's totally different from the stereotypical female singers that are very like sex oriented.
It's a very stereotype figure of the woman pop star.
Are you back for sleep? I'm trying to breathe, and I'll take my pleasure from everything.
I'd like Lebanese people to have a change in their conception of pop star music.
What we're saying is that women can also has another role to play, and you can be a woman and be a respected artist.
And you can be attractive and you can be free and you can be whatever you want, but just in another way.
Yeah. And I think, like, usually in general, like, Arab population is sick of this images of women, and I think all this thing is kind of start to change, so that's very good also.
Underground Cairo. What does Cairo mean to you? Ahmed Madbouli says Cairo for me starts after 1 a.m. It's always nice just cruise out the streets of Cairo after 1 or 2 a.m. Usually the emptiest time of the day. It's usually the most fun time to cruise the streets. We're talking about Cairo, the underground belly, the music, the people, the streets, the identity, the sense, the smell, the sound. I grew up listening to the call to prayer while watching the A-Team and Knight Rider. You know, so I'm one of those that are sort of stuck in the middle, and you'll find a lot of them in the Arab world. We have social and cultural traditions that have been around for hundreds, maybe some even thousands of years. The concept of individuality hasn't really blossomed yet. It's not as accepted as other parts, maybe in the West or other parts of the world. I'd say it's definitely a recent thing that people really want to get up and do something for themselves. A lot of them are just sick of the status quo. You can now log on and just type whatever you want to the world and spread it out. That has been a major difference in people's lives recently. I mean, this is something we haven't had. If you had an opinion, you'd write it on a piece of paper and you'd hide it in a desk because you're afraid of what people will think of your opinion. It's like the waves of an ocean. Each wave is sort of connected, but if one wave decides to move that way, then it'll affect the waves before and after it. So I guess people are realizing that, no, wait a minute, even with the smallest actions you can do, change is possible.
There is a huge difference between our generation and our parents. We're definitely much more liberal and rebellious. Our generation, if we don't like something, we just say it out loud. I moved out from my parents' house as they live in Alexandria. If a girl does that in Egypt, normally, she would have bad relationship with her parents. But my parents are very cool about it. At first they were like, okay, you go for 6 months and you come back because we miss you. But now they're dealing with me as an independent person. البنات لازم تبقى مكسوفة ومتزنة ومش ملهوفة الحرية أحلى محدودة مش فاهمة
My mom was not agreeing with this at all, but I had to find a way. I'm like, okay, I have a job waiting for me. I have to go. She thought it was temporary, but I can't go back.
We're brought up in this country to believe that the father is the caretaker, and being with your family is something that's it's safety. And if you get out of your family's
house, it's your husband's house.
It's your husband because you need someone to take care of you. Most women in this country, I'm going to speak about this country, all of the girls in our age, they're very submissive towards their parents, towards their boyfriends.
A lot of them, they won't stand up to themselves. There are a few of us who respond. This is what bothers me here. A few of us who respond to anyone bothering us in the street.
It's getting out of hand. There's this sexual tension and frustration here in men. Maybe it's because of the whole taboo issues and religion. It's all related to religion in the end. And then you open the television, the local TV, and there are video clips of half naked chicks. So how can you? It's all mixed up.
جوازي مؤقت بس حبي للأردن مؤبد حطيت الأردن على الخريطة وانتبهتك تتجبد مش لازم يكون عندي الرقم وطني عشان تقول إن وطني اتطمن من ربي طلبي لو التوفيق عايدك غصفيت دمك بالنقاش الأسنان يا حبيبي امك جاهل بكل شي ما عندك نضوش فكري تسأل عن عدتي قبل ما تسمعني شو بدك كلي بدلب بحالي ماخد بدفع أكثر ما باخد مع إنه عدتي بتنتهي بتامر قطع عادل كم قرش دخل جيبتي ما بيكافوه وصمهر لخطيب
In our board, it's a lot of different rules. There is always a red line. You can't be yourself sometimes. The culture in Jordan don't allow to speak with woman from yourself. If you want to hang out, just hang out with the girls. It's not easy. You know something, it's not important for me because I have a future. I'm thinking about hip-hop, how to create something. Sometimes when you really want something, you want to be unique and brilliant. Take all your time.
اهلا
اهلا
الاسم الكريم
اسمي سامر شقفه بحكوا لي الاستاذ سام
من وين جاي
من الاردن
شو بدك تقدم لنا اليوم
اغنيه تراب
اهلا فيك تفضل
هل يسام هو يلا كله يرفع ايديه لفوق زي هيك رقصوا الحريه محصن بعقله قلم وثقة وعلم مدون ممثل وكاتب بكتب اللي بحسه برسم اللي بشوفه حتى لو انه صاعد وعي تخريجه وانشوره انه قوة اجتمعت فكرت خططت طلعت قاومت كملت قررت انه ظلم انسان مانع علم حرية رافع ولو اطور سنين دافع نافع بارع بايع اي خادع واقع ضايع مايع راجع مايع رفش انه طفش طفش وهي انكشف وانا اللي كنت اظن ربتنا كاس الشايف يا عم فني بكل همة بنكمل مهمة احنا ايد واحدة متعاونين لنوصل قمة العدل والحرية والديمقراطية بيننا وتصلح مجتمعنا وتوعية الاجيال اللي بعنا اي حق يجي جنبينا او بخية هينة زلمة قلمة قلبة فضح وضرب وشطب وقلب وقلمة بطولة كلها حلوة
انه لحد الان في ناس بيمسكوا مثلا مراكز فنيه مهمه انك بتحتاجهم لسه بيعرفوش شو الفرق بين الراب والروك وبين عبد الشياطين
تشيك
هذا غرب هذا مش من هون مش كويس اند حرام دائما بيقول حرام هذا
عدت على ايديك كم اعلام تحت العد
على ايديك كم مقال حذف بدل ما ينزل كامل بنزل محذف محرف بنظف الجهه المعنيه لنضرب من بسمع عامل اي شخصيه كمواطن لازم افرق وجامل هيك الديمقراطيه العربيه والحاصل امشي جنب الحيط لما صير حيط مالي تاثير تغيير ولا ماسك طرف الخيط انا بحاول اكمل بس اللي بصير بكسر راسي بدي اتحمل والسبب اني اوصل الرساله عافضل حالي مش لازم امسك مركز كبير واكون عالي على الشعب نهب زي النار بهب باكل كل شي بكب اللي ما بنحسب غصب السياسه اللي ماشي واحنا المواشي نحرط ونمشي ما بدي امد ايدي ولا بدي تمد ايدك ضلك ضدي ندي بندي حددنا بدك يا ضدي فضي غضبك
حاليا المشاكل يعني لسه مشاكل هي الشكل مثلا ايش انت لابس شو انت حالك شو عم بتسوي كيف تتحرك شو عم بتغني شو موسيقتك ليش هيك بتسوي ليش هيك بتفكر هاي المشاكل يعني بنواجهها كجيل جيلي انا يعني
coffee for me represents the Arabic culture it's welcoming people it's something authentic and very simple you can see the raw materials not kind of Nescafe, very quick, in a hurry, you have to catch the metro. No, the Arabic coffee is a relaxed process. You boil the water with the coffee, you smell it, put it in small cups, drink it a bit by bit. I think it represents the Arab culture. I believe in art as a tool for social change. I see myself as an activist with artistic tools. I can mobilize people, I can convey ideas in a more appealing way. As an artist, you have a role. People are looking for meaning of life. And artists, I think, are the ones who can give them the direction. It's not the politicians. The politicians are stealing our dreams. Artists can bring it back to us.
On some of my posters, I use this kind of this character. He's kind of a dreamer. He does not believe in physics and what's possible and what's not possible. He's kind of representing the childish dreams in all of us.
I have a full list of things I want to change in the Arab culture. The top of the list is it's not waiting for help from outside. I don't believe in Lawrence of Arabia. You can do it yourself. This theory of the white man in Africa solving things. 1936, a poster designed by an Israeli artist before even establishing Israel, 12 years before establishing Israel. And he was asking the Jews to visit Palestine, to come to the Promised Land. And this is quite romantic image of Palestine, Dome of the Rock, Jerusalem with an olive tree, quite authentic poster. You can still see this scenery here in Palestine, but there is something new in the scene. So I recreated the poster with the wall blocking the scenery, destroying the landscape. We as a generation, I feel that we don't respect anything anymore. This is a major difference between us and the older generation. We don't respect anything or anybody. Everything is questionable. We are questioning religion, political system, the international communities, our culture, our habits. Everything is questionable. And this is, I think, step one to do to make things better.
Oh, 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 oh.
Back in 96, the scene I used to belong to was the rock scene. We all shared a big dream of becoming, you know, like rock stars, and all sharing the same dream, the same hobby, the same passion. And the rock scene disappeared that year. The government considered all the rockers like satanics, and they worshipped Satan. They stopped all the concerts, and most of the musicians just quit playing. Everything disappeared. It was a big shock. It's like as if you had to immigrate from your homeland because of war. And you have to change everything, the way you look, the way you dress. Your friends are not the same. At that time, playing a distortion guitar was prohibited. It was something satanic. The only bands I can play with that are not mainstream were jazz. What we want is freedom. Freedom of expression, wearing what I want, doing my hair the way I want, play what I want. Us as musicians, we're probably hypersensitive. We're very affected by maybe a look, an aggressive look or a judgmental look would ruin your day, would fuck your mood. So I think we notice the very, very small details.
I live with my mom. For us, living with your parents is something you choose, but something you have to do, unless you want to be a rebellion. For me, basically, I'm living with my mom, so I make sure that I'm taking care of her.
Please don't try this at home.
Music for us is not something that's really appreciated, or it's not something likable. I mean, for us, it's something shameful. Biggest problem for youth is freedom of choice, even if it's a better option. You have to go to school and to go to university and work in a decent company. So you have to be an engineer or a doctor, otherwise you won't be respectful. I try to separate my two lives. All my jobs, I never told them that I play music. I feel like Spider-Man sometimes. I don't switch off. Even when I'm work, I'm always occupied by music. Music is my main passion. It's the thing that wakes me up in the morning. So without it, I to be honest, I don't feel that my life is worth anything.
عمري ما حبطل جناني مش مهم عمري ما حبطل جناني عمري ما حبطل جناني عمري ما حبطل جناني مش مهم
amount of awareness that you can find in the new generation of Arabs is related to politics and related to the amount of struggles in the area because it affects your daily life.
we're in the same region, we have the same political, socioeconomic situations, we're trying to challenge the same norms.
I think we're really isolated until today by our frontiers. What's particular with the Arab region is that there is not this so-called unity. We all look at each other as strangers. In our hearts, we have the dream of this Arab unity, but even between a neighborhood and a neighborhood, there are strong frontiers. I love that the word relate to Arab with no reference whatsoever to the religion or the religion principles. It would be nice.
Why would it be nice?
Because the whole world is afraid of the Arab world because of the fanatics, Islamists, like. Most of the Western world think that all the Arabs are Muslim fanatics.
I really don't care about how West will see us. I really don't care. I don't care of the, if they will feel more secure if they consider us like enemies, because they need an enemy. So this is their problem. It's not my problem. My problem is it's my life here.
We share the same problems. We still close our eyes on the problems of the West or the East. So, yeah, it's important that anywhere in any part of the world there's real understanding. People understand that we have a common dream, common. We share the same problems and the same hopes. So we have to be all satisfied with our lives because we will make other people unhappy.
مش خط ملون بخصر السهل ولا الاسمنت اللي في قلبي وعقلبه مش كرسي منجل في مجلس كهل ولا ملف سيارة عبابه مش فكرة كانت امبارح ولا فكرة كانت مفتاح معلق مش قلب كبير محروس بجنون مش بلد فيتامي ورقم قوي مرسوم حرة فلسطين زي نسمة هوا مرفوعة عن الليالي مرفوعة للسماء عيون الناس تنام تصحى هي أحلامنا تصحى فلسطين كل يوم وكل بنت وكل ولد كل البلد
Ramallah is like the last oasis for Palestinian civilization. It's the last oasis for us. We always say that Ramallah thinks herself as a city, and we let her act like a city. While it's a small town, it's not a city, but we let her be a city. If we don't see her as a city, nobody else will. You know, to have a personal life here, you have to adjust to many facts that are not very normal. Like you cannot move, you cannot go from A to B, you cannot go. All you have to do is stay in your city and try to make your life as simple as possible in the allowed space that we have. It's hard, but you know, occupation is like this.
وين القى علامة لا طاقة ولا شرخ بس هو طوله 200 هامة وين اصل انا من دلولا سمولي دليلي وذولا في الجبل ودلوه في نهاري وليلي
you're talking about what touches people on a personal level, it is still about freedom, freedom of movement, freedom of thoughts, freedom of just going to the sea, just going to the sea. Sometimes we smell it, you know, when the wind is coming from that side, you smell the sea, but you can't go to it. So you cannot say the sea issue is political, but it is political. It is very political. The beach, the sand, it is political. It's how can you separate politics from life in here? Even if you try, you'll hit the wall.
I think an artist in a place under occupation, a country under occupation, has a lot of things to do. Many people consider music or art as like, this is not fighting. I don't agree with that. It's all a fight. It's one big fight. You have to change the weapon. A bullet would make a big sound. A song would make bigger. So I think it's just switching between a gun and a guitar, but the aim is the same.
Search me, I'm an Arab, I'm a walking bomb, straight up from the land of martyrdom. Check out every airport, check out every checkpoint. Search me, I'm an Arab, I'm a walking bomb. Yeah, I'm a terrorist, but I'm one of those whom you will never expect. I'm one of those whom out of your mind you will never get. Yeah, I'm a terrorist, but no rifle on my back. No explosives in my bag. No TNT in my pants. I just need a one shot of chance. With that one shot, I'll shoot you a bullet of poetry. I'll assassinate you with a monologue. I'll suicide bomb you with a freestyle dance. And I'll torture you with the rhythm of my bass drum. And I'll demolish your house with a song out of my folk. Come drink with me some of my Arabic coffee. Ain't that a kidnap attempt? Yeah, I'm a terrorist. Yeah, I'm one of a different kind. Yeah, I'm a terrorist, but I'm one of those that you will never expect.
I was born and raised in Haifa, but originally I'm not from Haifa. I'm from a destroyed village, a displaced village called Iqrith. It's on top, on the northern borders with Lebanon. It was displaced in 1948 with its people. My grandparents are internal refugees, what are called internal refugees. So they are refugees inside the state of Israel after it took its independence. يعني احنا اللي عم نحارب عشان نثبت بقاء هوية هاي البلاد الأصلية. لولانا احنا احترام للكل ينسوا اللاجئين وينسوا كل العالم عن حق عودي. لولا احنا مش موجودين هون كان من زمان الناس نسيت شو يعني عودي. انه احنا هون هذا بعطي قوة للناس انها تفكر انه في امل انه نرجع.
حركة تبكي is the ministry. ويلا هلا جاي جاي رصد فلسطيني جاي تشحلب التاريخ من النهاية للبداية جاي جاي رصد فلسطيني جاي تشحلب التاريخ من النهاية للبداية على أوطار العود وعون جارتي الحدا
يا باتش عم بيصوت ولا يا باتش عم بيصوت طرحك بس نحش الفصلني يردو حلال يا مالي وإذا تسألني مالي بقولنا لا ولا شي بس شاير راسها ماني صحي كل إنسان كلمة عديدة تخضن بكل مخ كل دن موسيقى للجوعان موسيقى للعطشان إذا أروح هي موسيقى الإنسان أغربني أسمعني يا فنان وسرقني على عالم ما بتحرك بالزمن ورمان 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 إذا قرب دبا ربا دبا ربا دبا إذا قرب أدب أتاك إذا قرب دبا ربا دبا ربا دبا إذا قرب أدب أتاك إذا قرب دبا ربا دبا ربا دبا إذا قرب أدب أتاك إذا قرب دبا ربا دبا ربا دبا
نذكر إنه إحنا كمان مش بس بنعمل موسيقى مبسوطين والحياة جميلة عنا يعني أنا برأيي الموسيقى هي إشي سامي ورسالة بنفس الوقت اللي ناس تاني تطلع على الموسيقى أخطر من الكلاتشينكوف بس إنه نعمل موسيقى اللي هي ممكن تقول لك أو مان في إشي اللي عم تحكيه موسيقى اللي بتفتح لك مخك مرات لأنه خلص نمشي زي العبيد زي القطيع ماشيين ورا بعض ورا بعض ورا بعض ولما توقف تقول لا بدي أنت صوتي يحكي بدي أعبر عن آرائي بمسكوك بآمن بالقومية العربية إنه إذا أنا عربي إيم ديني على جنب أنت عربي قبالي فكل العرب اللي بالدول العربية إخوتي فكتير بأسف إنه في كتير ناس عندها كبت موسيقي وبيقدروش يجوا موسيقى عشان السيستم الكبير والبابلون ما بدين يعملوا هيك شيء.
Position is that the military should not interfere in politics in general. This is like a base rule for democracy. And so I wrote a song, it's a message, it's not a big deal. I don't have a problem against the president particularly. And at the end they decided that I was insulting the president and that it's against the law. I think there are charges since they let me go out of the country. I'm here in the US. That our government supports Syria. Like one singer that was critic to the government was found murdered and his throat was cut as a message. And this is the kind of violence I'm afraid. The Syrian government is ferocious. They don't accept critics. The supporters of their current regime are very violent. And it's just an hour away from here. There's a real pressure on every Arab artist, pressure from the government. I got sent to jail for a stupid sentence. That's the worst. And Egypt, they imprison bloggers, they imprison singers. In Syria, they kill the singers. In Jordan, you cannot say, I'm against the king, I'm for democracy, you go to jail. That's oppression. Everywhere, that's the worst of Arabic culture.
My generation was always being told by our parents and our peers that you guys are an unlucky generation, you know. You're in this horrible economic time, you're in this horrible oppressive regime, and it got to a point where we were literally 85 million people just waiting for this one man to die, just to see what's next.
There's a screen between you and the actual event going on, so you're just participating, but for a moment you don't think that you're gonna get hurt until you get hit the first time. That's when you, woo, what's happening? The screen falls and you're back to reality and shit.
I've witnessed death and I was ready to die, scared, terrified, but very happy and very proud. I refused to do any songs or anything. It was the time where you, as an artist and as a man, you just put your instrument aside, you hold your weapon, and you go and fight and fight for your freedom, and you protect your family.
Fear for your life for the first couple of days, and then it was gone. It was just gone. I'm going to the square because I believe that this is where I need to be, this is what I need to do. And then one day after the other, until Mubarak sort of stepped down, and to me that was a start of something beautiful.
The president just stepped down. This is happening. History.
نعمل اغنيه مثلا بتتكلم عن مستقبل الباهر اللي انا هيبقى موجود هنا مع الاخوان. العلاقه الجديده اللي هتتم بيننا وبين الاخوان.
نكتب فعلا المستقبل الباهر مع ال
لا فاكس طبعا.
فمش عامل اي اغنيه عندهم اصلا.
فاكس طبعا.
طبعا شفت اغنيه
الاغنيه اللي عاملينها
ايه ده؟ فكروا كده؟
كده. فكر يا كبير، فكر يا كبير، فكر. ما لازم نتكلم في السياسة، ما نتكلم في ايه؟ ايه؟ انا على فكرة مش بهرج، احنا خلال 10 سنين لازم نكون عاملين حزب واحد مية داخل الانتخابات. بهرجش
انت، ماليش دعوة انت ايه اللي اصلا انت هتخش الانتخابات
خلال 10 سنين؟ ما لازم اكون حزب عشان اخش الانتخابات. ما انا اخش فرضاني.
طب تعالى تاني حزب اسمه ايه بقى ان شاء الله؟
حزب امك حلوة.
دنيا موليد يا ناس، والناس بتتفرج، في ناس تقرب لناس، وناس بتتهرب.
Difference between us and the old generation, we got more balls. Let's put it that way. They're from a generation that existed when the oppression started, and they're very scared. Politics was a taboo in Egypt for a long time. Couldn't really talk about it. That's the main difference between us and them. Even till now, during the revolution, they're the ones who are trying to pump our brakes while we are trying to get the demands achieved. They're like, hey, we achieved as much as we can, man. You know, just calm down now and stop going to Tahrir. We're like, fuck you, shut the fuck up. You made us go through this for 30 years. You don't even have a say anymore.
We are used as Palestinians to be the headlines. Now, in the Arab Spring, we were not the headlines anymore. This time, we were watching the other Arab nations going through their revolution, seeking freedom and liberty and dignity. And we were so involved, and as if we are in Egypt, and Mubarak is our president slash dictator. And we were really frustrated that he's taking that long. When he resigned slash gone to hell, the feeling was really weird. We are not used to succeed. We are not used for the happy endings. As Palestinians, I think we are jealous nowadays that revolutions are not only for Palestinians. Egypt in 19 days, they changed their future once and forever. We've been negotiating for the last 19 years and we are still stuck in the same fucking situation.
والله يعلم المنطقة العربية كلها في حالة تغيير، فبدها ناس تمشي مع هذا التغيير. ثورة الربيع العربي، ما انت شايف الثورات مصر وتونس وليبيا وسوريا، يعني جيلكم بده يشوف شيء غير جيلنا.
الهيب هوب سامر لما تكلم فعلا هادف كويس، هذا اللي بحبه انا. وان شاء الله ربنا بيوفقه وبيطلع وبيعلى يعني بالهيب هوب تبعه هذا. انا بشجعه يعني على حاجه هذه.
شكرا.
ماي مام حبيبي مام.
الله يرضى عليك.
لكن انا مواضيعه بتعجبني يعني، يعني بتكلم عن الحريه، بتكلم عن الفساد، عن الروتين، عن المشاكل الاجتماعيه. يعني ممكن هو يطرح مشاكل الشباب، مشاكل المشاكل الاجتماعيه عموما، وممكن يطرح المشاكل السياسيه.
عمل انا حريه وفي بلد
مع بعض
حريه عن طريق وسيلي سالك.
لا هسه شوف بحكي عارفك عنا احنا رسل، انتوا كلكم تحكوا بعض حريه وفي مع بعضنا بسم. يلا
اعرفك عنا احنا رسل
حريه،
قاعدين مع بعضنا باسم
حريه،
الدافع عنا بتضمن حقك
حريه.
عندي اهداف كتير في المجتمع بستخدم الهيب هوب فيها. كتير بهمني الجيل الثاني الجديد يطلع مش جاهل فنيا، مش عنده نوع معين من الموسيقى بس، يطلع فهمان، يطلع كيف ذكي، يطلع يعني يبني البلد، يعني يكمل بناء البلد، يعني احنا نأسس له وهو كمل.
I'm happy with the Arab Spring. Every revolution that is happening is great. I feel so happy. I support it because I do not see good guys in front. You know, I never saw a good dictator. I don't believe in this concept.
One, two.
I tell you that the movie I scored the music for, it was censored 2 days ago.
No.
It won't play in Lebanon.
Okay. Oh.
Isn't it funny?
Why?
Because they considered the movie to be a threat to national security. See how amazing. We're so dangerous for the nation. We're really dangerous. My mama won't be proud of me. The Middle East is not going backward, it's going forward in terms of I don't know Egypt, what is going to happen. After revolutions are always bloody and dirty, so the people must, they still need huge sacrifices from the whole people until they reach a stable society. So yeah, I'm scared because it's a moment of great violence.
Don't say you're looking hard on me.
I'm going to vote. I have been waiting for that day. I mean, everyone was waiting for that day. I'm not really sure. I'm sure which party I'm gonna vote for. I'm not really sure which person, individual I'm gonna vote for, because I've never done it before. I was never interested in politics. I don't really read newspapers. I don't watch TV, you know, as long as it's a movie, but I don't watch, you know, the news or anything. But now I think, you know, people care more and I care more, and it makes me think that I can be a part of, you know, the result that comes out. So I feel that this is, you know, my contribution. This is something that I have shared or something that I have contributed. But I'm hoping this could be a positive step for people, even if it doesn't look like a perfect future, but eventually people will learn how to vote and, you know, have more control on their future and the people they choose and the political parties. Changing governments and people is not gonna, you know, affect the lives of the people unless they try to change themselves in the beginning. So I don't see close change coming or new change coming in the future unless people start changing themselves.
We were not divided. Now we are. Before the revolution, we were all, you know, with all the sects and different opinions and different beliefs against the government and the regime. But now we are divided into liberals, into Muslims, and even the Muslims are divided into two. There's a major change in all aspects of your life.
كان وكان يا مكان مركب لها قطار والوحده عالدفة بيميل الكفة طمعان وما استكفى مع انه كان شبعان ناسي ان في تانيين عالمركبة عايشين في الاصل ملكها من ظلمه مش لاقين واستحملوه ياما لكنه ما تعلمش ولانهم ياما الحلم ما استسلمش واحد ورا واحد حاول لكن ما عرفش واما بقوا واحد اتقوا على السكان وكان طمعان وما استكفى مع انه كان شبعان.
If the Muslim Brotherhood, Muslim Brothers, if they take over, that's it. They just want, you know, Muslims and a specific type of Muslims. You know, the Salafis and Sunnis. Probably I'm gonna switch, you know, like I won't be able to play my guitar anymore. I think the only instrument they allow is duf. You know the duf? The drum?
Society becomes Islamic, and if this happens, I'd either have to leave the country. I don't think I want to do this. Or I stay and pretend to be like one of those, which is not an option. So I could be this mad individual. I don't know. I hope that I can belong here and be stronger to tolerate what's going to happen.
Was our mistake as people from Tahrir Square in general that we left Tahrir Square on February 11th. We were all played with after that. It was a show. Our generation is not idiots and we're not gonna bow down. And anybody who's gonna tell us to, yeah, be more peaceful, yeah, enough is enough, fuck you, go leave Egypt. We don't want you here anymore. We don't want cowards in Egypt anymore. Egyptians are not cowards.
The revolutionary spirit has definitely been instilled in lots and lots of people, and I think those are the people that are paving the path for the future. So unfortunately, as with any beautiful thing, lots of people will try and destroy it. And that's what's happening right now. This revolution is not for us, it's not for our kids, I think it's for our grandkids. And we're gonna have to learn to talk to each other and listen to each other. Bringing an end to all the negativity that we have in Egypt, bringing an end to all the terrible concepts that we were living with. And in all honesty, I really feel lucky to be part of this generation.
I believe that change is always for the best, but what really oppresses me most is the dictatorship of religion. Mm. And so this needs a huge revolution, you know. People need to understand how to practice their faith in a respectful way. So that's the thing that frightens me a bit, mm. is how much God is... heavy on our shoulders, you know, every day.
I think there's a lot of work still to be done in the perception that we as Lebanese or Arabs are seen in other parts of the world. I think people in Europe, if we were able to change or to add something to their knowledge, that's the biggest achievement. You can change things in big scale by starting very, very small scale.
We are very, very proud to present Zeid and the Wings. They flew in from all over the world to be here tonight in the Bali, here in Amsterdam. And just give them a warm, warm applause. Zeid and the Wings!
The song goes to all the military who should hand the power to the civilians. Man, go home.
General Suleiman. General.
سليمان سلام 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 عليك جنرال سليمان You're a miracle man for peace in a nation جنرال سليمان You're a miracle man جنرال سليمان You're a miracle man I experienced there were a group of Guys, when you said like General Suleiman, go home, they were like, go home to you. Go home, go home.
Yeah, listen,
I heard
everywhere
that.
I sing the song, they have people say that to me.
What made me afraid was that one of them said he's not gonna reach the airport.
Oh man, I didn't hear that.
No, you didn't hear. No. Are you serious? Yes.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Well, anyway, it doesn't matter. This everywhere this happens, these things. Now, where is your next city? Where are you going now?
I'm not gonna reach the airport.
Put your weapons down. Put your weapons down. Now it's time to leave your warlords behind. Everything.
I just create a song that I feel. It's a nice translation of thoughts and ideas, and then people live with it, you know, it becomes theirs. And when you meet those people, you have a link without having met them, because they shared something very personal. And I feel comfortable with those people, they are my friends. And I owe that to music. It's a pastoral to the whole world. I owe everything to music, man. I met a lot of people, not only from Lebanon, and everyone has the same dreams. Most people I meet just want to, you know, enjoy this fucking life, you know. I don't have a bigger dream now. I have a lot of dreams. Falling in love. Oh man, I love falling in love. That's a dream. As simple as that. A beautiful person that is completely inspiring. Then I would be ready to do anything. Just to please her. I like that. I'm not afraid of that. If it comes, I accept it.
What's happening around the world is clearly collective consciousness, and I'm happy to have tapped into that. You know, the world is changing, there's a new energy rising, and it's a young energy. We're all counting on this new energy to take us where we want to go, I guess.
The next coming years aren't going to be easy. It's not going to be bright instantly. My hopes towards the future is that I wish people become more tolerant toward the other and become more aware that people should be different. If we're all the same, then this is not living. It's not real life.
My fear is that in 40 years, we will be hoping for another revolution to get rid of the regimes we will get now. But this is only a fear. When you have a taste of the freedom and the dignity, you can't live without anymore. And I think we had this taste of freedom and dignity. I don't think we are going back.
فهذا أكثر شيء يكون حاب إنه غير وجهة النظر عنا يعني.
Cultural resistance people believe in cultural resistance because the oppressor is afraid of culture. That is our weapon.
We are going far from where our fathers and grandfathers stood. If we have a Palestinian state, I will start singing love stories. My goal is to go to Al-Quds. If my gun couldn't take me, maybe my guitar.
I've been experiencing so much conflicts in the last few years that I think whatever happened, we'll always find a way to just continue building and struggling to make our lives, you know, something decent. Whatever the crisis, I mean, we've been through civil wars and then invasions and then bombings and then... It's been crazy and we've managed to survive, so I think it's in our essence, you know, the will to build and build and build whatever happens.
I'm living my dream. It's a real dream. I have achieved my dream. I am free and I'm doing my music. But I don't own anything. I have no security. I'll get old without money on the side. And I don't know what tomorrow is made of. I don't know. I have no security whatsoever. I just have the comfort of achieving my dream, you know? Reality is a gift. I wake up gifted. I'm lucky.
فوقنا خلف